Are you ready for some political talk?
Voters coming through, make way, make way. Voters coming through. Family, breathe the democracy.
Ah, yes, breathe in the democracy. Hi, it's me. I basically came here to share a video. It's about Justin Trudeau, our Prime Minister, and how to become a tyrant. How are those two things put together? Well, one day I was watching Netflix and a docuseries called How to Become a Tyrant. And as I kept watching, I kept thinking, man, there are some real similarities going on with what's happening today and with what's happening in this docuseries. So the docuseries takes from a playbook on how to become a tyrant. You know what? Before I continue, let me show you the preview of How to Become a Tyrant, which I highly recommend.
If you want to rule, you first have to believe that you can. To truly show your love, you'll need to guide your flock with a firm hand. You too can create an enduring heaven on earth with you as its guiding light.
When you're living in a difficult time, there's an appeal to someone who says, I alone can fix it all.
If you want to make history, you'll need a message that stirs people's souls.
Many Germans found that he was saying what they thought secretly, but had never been able to express.
It's very easy for us to go, I would never fall for the seductive charms of a tyrant like Hitler. I promise you, you would.
Absolute rule is going to take a strong stomach.
Torture is a very good way to deter people from opposing you.
Toughness is good. The people respect you.
Saddam's keeping fear alive with intention.
Gaddafi was expert at manipulating the media.
One of the most powerful tools is who controls the information.
True, the party decides what is true. There is a higher truth. That is the truth of power.
You still have some big challenges to overcome.
Now is the time to overthrow the regime of death.
Time to show how far you're willing to go to preserve your power.
Surely, this couldn't be happening in Canada, right? So before I continue, just want to say I'm not very good at this. I'm very much an amateur, so please bear with the editing and all the other stuff that goes with making a video. I'm doing the best I can with the resources I got. So this documentary begins by saying that a tyrant must believe in themselves. If you want to rule, you must first believe that you can. Dictators are not only highly confident, they're focused and narcissistic. But they believe that they're the only ones who can save the world and make it a better place. Our leader has certainly displayed these traits.
I was put on this planet to do this. This is I fight and I win.
You fight from a good place. Is that confidence enough for you? Well, if confidence alone isn't enough, how about our Prime Minister's thoughts on dictators?
There's a level of admiration I actually have for China. Because their basic dictatorship is allowing them to actually turn their economy around.
So you admire a basic dictatorship. Nice. You might be surprised to hear that this isn't the only time that our Prime Minister said nice things about a dictator. When Fidel Castro passed away, here is what Trudeau had to say.
Alrighty then.
Okay, Episode 1 is about seizing power with a focus on Adolf Hitler. You might have heard of him. One thing from the playbook is brand your movement. Check out this for branding.
You want a government with a vision and an agenda for this country that is positive and ambitious and hopeful. Well, my friends, I promise you tonight that I will lead that government.
I understand one of the priorities for you was to have a cabinet that was gender balanced. Why was that so important to you?
Because it's 2015.
Maternal love is the love that's going to change the future of mankind. So we'd like you to look
at that. We'd like to say people kind, not necessarily mankind.
I'm going to keep saying loud and clearly that I am a feminist.
You might not say, oh, what does a gender lens have to do with building this new highway or this new pipeline or something? Well, there are gender impacts. When you bring construction workers into a rural area, there are social impacts because they're mostly male construction workers.
Politically correct much? Okay, there we have the brand. How's his passion for economic policy?
The commitment needs to be a commitment to grow the economy, and the budget will balance itself.
Right.
Nothing says opportunity like a good crisis. On February 27th, 1933, the German Parliament Reichstag building burned down. The Nazi leadership and its coalition partners used the fire to claim that communists were planning a violent uprising. They claimed that emergency legislation was needed to prevent this. The resulting act, commonly known as the Reichstag Fire Decree, abolished a number of constitutional protections and paved the way for Nazi dictatorship. Fast forward 89 years later, and a little problem with a virus we have. A protest in the nation's capital occurred to draw attention to and change government pandemic mandates. Well, the result?
The federal government has invoked the Emergencies Act to supplement provincial and territorial capacity to address the blockades and occupations.
And when that Emergency Act was enacted, it was like out of a scene from a very, very famous movie. Since then, the question on why the government went to such extremes has been asked. The leader of the Liberals' answer?
When illegal blockades hurt workers and endangered public safety, police were clear that they needed tools not held by any federal, provincial, or territorial law. It was only after we got advice from law enforcement that we invoked the Emergencies Act.
Did yourself or anyone in the OPS request the invocation of the Emergency Act?
I did not make that request. I'm not aware of anybody else in the Auto Police Service who did.
As I make this video, there is a trial going on to see exactly if the Emergency Act was an overreach or justified. We shall see what happens. Okay, that's chapter one, and I've just compared our prime minister to Adolf Hitler. Now, I am going to stress this. I'm not saying they are the same, and I'm not making any accusation that he is this guy, because Adolf Hitler was next level evil. What I am saying is that he has taken plays from his tyrannical playbook to use to his own advantage. If you think I'm the only one that thinks this, think again.
But he was talking about people who are not vaccinated. He said they don't believe in science. They're often misogynistic, often racist. No, they're not.
That was not smart of him at all.
Right. He said, but they take up space.
Mm.
And with that, we have to make a choice in terms of a leader as a country. Do we tolerate these people? It's like, tolerate these? Now you do sound like Hitler.
It's funny because it's true.
He not only sounded like Hitler, but he definitely took plays from this chapter's tyrannical playbook, like branding your movement and using crisis to your advantage.
In the next episode, good old Saddam Hussein and his play, Crush Your Rivals.
First, there was Jody Wilson-Raybould, Canada's first Indigenous Justice Minister. On April 2, 2019, Trudeau expelled Wilson-Raybould from the Liberal caucus in the House of Commons and stripped her of her Liberal Party nomination for the 2019 Canadian federal election. Then there was Jane Philpott, who was Minister of Health in the cabinet of the 29th Canadian Ministry, headed by Justin Trudeau. That same day as Wilson-Raybould, Philpott was expelled from the Liberal parliamentary caucus. Now, do resignations count? If so, Gerald Butts resigned as Prime Minister Justin Trudeau's principal secretary in an eyebrow-raising move. In this chapter, yes, you must crush your rivals, but you must strike deals as well. Just like Justin Trudeau, who struck a deal with...
the Rolex wearing, diamond ring wearing, kiss stealing, woo, wheeling dealing, limousine riding, jet flying, son of a gun.
And I am having a hard time understanding how the NDP leader represents the working class. Anyway, this deal will ensure that the Trudeau government is in power full term until 2025.
Another thing out of the playbook in this chapter is simply be everywhere. Pictures, murals in this public square, or statues of yourself. For our local leader, there is a statue of his dad, but I could find little else other than a sculpture of Trudeau made from butter. Saying that, it would be tough to deny that Justin Trudeau loves the photo op, whether it's at the Pride Parade, Black Lives Matter, Reconciliation of Indigenous People, or simply at a children's school. The louder the movement, the better the photo op opportunity.
This next chapter is called Reign Through Terror and focuses on the tactics used by Idi Amin from Uganda.
Ever read The Prince by Niccolo Machiavelli? It's another playbook of power, and it raises the age-old question.
Is it better to be loved or feared?
That's a good question. It's nice to be both, but it's very difficult. But if I had my choice, I would rather be feared.
And so did Idi Amin. He agreed with this wholeheartedly and took it to the next level. In this episode, it discusses things like conceal your brutality, and know the value of a good cover-up. There is also the play of choosing a scapegoat. This can unify people to your side. One thing from the playbook that I think we've seen here is weaponize the law. To reign supreme, sometimes laws can be a barrier and get in the way. So the idea here is to weaken the institutions and the guardrails that serve as a check on your power. And once those guardrails are down, you are free to turn the law against your scapegoat. As I mentioned earlier in the video, we see this in our country.
The federal government has invoked the Emergencies Act to supplement.
Now, that's the most popular topic of the day and the most glaring example. But there is a different example. To give you that, April 2020, when the government was accused of pressuring the RCMP police to release information about weapons used in the Nova Scotia mass shooting to further the Liberals' gun control legislation.
We did not put any undue influence or pressure.
We continue to have support, have confidence in the commissioner. Ultimately, as we know, police make the determination on what information to release and when.
Now, the type of weapons were not known at the point of the interview, but listen and watch Public Safety Minister Bill Blair read from his notes.
The responsibility for identifying the weapons that were used in Nova Scotia is with the RCMP, and the release of any information pertaining to those is theirs.
We would later learn that the Prime Minister was later briefed on the exact weapons used. So,
We know that the government had information it wanted to underline its case for specific measures. Now, the rest of the Ugandan dictators was filled with torture and war. Now, I got to be honest here and be realistic. I can't say that Trudeau has done any of that in his term. Obviously, we're in a civilized country. But our guy certainly did a lot to promote fear.
And he certainly interfered with and weaponized the law.
So now I've just compared Justin Trudeau to another insane dictator. You know, and I'm trying to feel a little bad here, but it's not just me. Have a listen to one of the most famous podcasters on the planet talk about Justin Trudeau.
Oh, you're a fucking dictator.
Yeah.
Oh, you don't like criticism. You're trying to shut down criticism by saying that all your critics are misogynists and racists.
Yeah.
You hear he said that about the trucking people, the truckers?
He called them?
Called them all misogynists and racists.
Oof.
Yeah, he's gross. He's a sketchy guy. He just cast a pejorative label on them with no evidence, with no provocation. It was just like, I'm going to label them this so that then I can impose laws to stop them from doing.
On to the next chapter, which is called Control the Truth with your tyrant friend, Joseph Stalin. Now, few tyrants fought the war on truth like this man, and he used propaganda and misinformation and other clever tricks. He controlled the media and thus people's lives and minds. Justin Trudeau definitely takes from this chapter of the playbook. I mean, to start, the government funds the media with taxpayers' dollars. And it's not like he hides it with really bad jokes.
You sometimes hear about liberal bias in the media these days, how they're constantly letting our government off the hook for no good reason. Frankly, I think that's insulting. It's clear that they let us off the hook for a very good reason, because we paid them $600 million. You don't get stellar headlines like these without greasing the wheels a bit.
While the opposition party are suggesting to decrease or eliminate funding, Trudeau and the Liberals are advocating to increase this spend.
As for other areas of media control and censoring everything, check out Bill C-11. Look it up. It's referred to as the Online Streaming Act, and it intends to highlight and promote Canadian content and would put online content under jurisdiction of the CRTC. Now, promoting Canadian content sounds great, but remember, this would be government-controlled, and government-regulating media of any kind? No. Now, Joseph Stalin had a unique approach to science, but his approach led to famine, not reported in the media. During COVID-19, our Prime Minister's knowledge of science deepened.
We're going to continue to follow the science.
Science!
We have had Canadians' backs by following the science.
Science!
From the beginning of this pandemic, we have followed science.
Science!
We will continue to follow the science.
She blinded me with science.
Now, while Stalin's view on science was dictated by ideological dogma, Trudeau's view on science was simply political science.
Oh, it's funny because it's true.
One last thing to point out in the playbook in this chapter is eliminate trust. Destroys people's faith in each other is a powerful tool, because then they must turn to the leader. This is so true in Canada and our neighbors right now. I ask you, have we ever lived in a modern day with such division in our society? Try talking politics at the dinner table tomorrow or tonight. That is, if you still sit down as a family at the dinner table.
Again, to demonstrate that this isn't just me that thinks that Trudeau's behavior is tyrannical, I found a video of when European leaders gathered in March of 2022. Have a listen to what Croatian Mislav Kolasovic, I'll probably butcher that name, the member of the European Parliament, had to say.
Canada, nekada simbol modernog svijeta, je pod vodstvom vaše kvaziliberalne čizme proteklih mjeseci postala simbol kršenja temeljnih ljudskih prava i građanskih sloboda. Za vas su to možda liberalne metode. Međutim, za mnoge građane svijeta, to je diktatura najgore vrste.
And then what about the comments made by German Member of Parliament Christine Anderson, who echoed similar sentiments?
Then again, a prime minister who openly admires the Chinese basic dictatorship, who tramples on fundamental rights by persecuting and criminalizing his own citizens as terrorists just because they dared to stand up to his perverted concept of democracy, should not be allowed to speak in this house at all. Mr. Trudeau, you are a disgrace for any democracy. Please spare us your presence. Thank you.
Episode number 5, Create a New Society with Your Dictator, Muammar Gaddafi.
Gaddafi was a completely different type of tyrant. He came from nothing and rose to power at a coup of the age of 26. He wanted to create a heaven on earth with him as the guiding light. With Trudeau, we can say that his actions, anecdotally, is the same, but not much more than that. One play from the playbook that Trudeau did take in this chapter is be the law. As Gaddafi wanted to guide his flock with a firm hand by limiting the rights the public enjoys, so does our prime minister. Gaddafi prohibited free speech and rights of assembly. When he saw people didn't share his vision, he became increasingly autocratic. For example, Gaddafi crushed the students' protest in 1976 with his army, and he hung 2 students for their participation. Other playbook items include building your legacy and indoctrinating the youth. Gaddafi built his legacy by building a truly incredible water pipe, unheard of in Libya. Our government legacy seems to be catering to the radical left and climate change. As far as in indoctrinating the youth, Gaddafi was very extreme by making this thing called the Green Book, the Bible of Gaddafi. Where Trudeau, again, is more subtle, but he participates in this nonetheless.
I don't believe in proportional representation. I don't think it's a good idea. I did commit to replacing the first-past-the-post system. I love the idea of a ranked ballot where you get to pick your first choice. You know, pick the red guy first, and then the orange girl second, and the green person third, and then you never get the blue person if that's the way you choose to vote.
This was Justin Trudeau in front of high school students answering a question from a student, telling them how he was going to do the exact opposite of what his campaign promise was. Now, isn't that a great message to young people in school? It's not the Green Book of Gaddafi, but definitely a red book of Trudeau.
Is there a little similarity there? Whoa, I think there is.
On to the last chapter, and that is Rule Forever with Kim Il-sung of North Korea. This chapter talks about keeping it in the family, and North Korea has been ruled by the Kim family for a very, very long time. Kim Il-sung, Kim Jong-il, and Kim Jong-un. Now, for this chapter, it is more tongue-in-cheek when I compare it to Trudeau, because he is the son of a famous leader that, not this guy. Seriously, this is the second time that a Trudeau is a Prime Minister of Canada. Very little else here from the playbook we can say Trudeau has taken from. Well, that is unless you take that let people starve to death at heart. I mean, the Kims, they let people starve because the starving are no threat to you. But, you know, at this time of making this video, the food bank usage across Canada hits an all-time high, nearly 1.5 million visits in March. That's a big yikes. Hurting? Yes. Starving? Well, not just yet. But will we? The Trudeau government is planning on reducing fertilizer use by farmers by 30%. To combat climate change. Farmers have said that this is seriously going to impact food output. Are we starving yet? We'll see about that.
Alright, so we've come to the end of the episodes on how to become a tyrant. I'm going to repeat that it's a great docuseries, especially if you like history and tactics on achieving power. I tried to keep this light and funny, but I can't escape the fact that I made a bold statement here. I mean,
I just said that Justin Trudeau was a tyrant, right?
No!
No! No! No! No! No!
Yes, a bit.
Okay. The series did make me think about Justin Trudeau on his tyrannical power. But I say it again, I'm not suggesting that Justin Trudeau is exactly like any of these guys mentioned in this docuseries. What is clear to me is that he definitely uses tactics from the playbook. I've thrown in some clips about others supporting my argument. How about the man himself?
Attack politics, divisive politics, negative, stirring up of hate and fear and differences. The dirty secret is they work. Mm. Even back in 2015, they work to get you elected.
Even back in 2015.
You can do that. You can mobilize and get elected. It's just what we're seeing is that once you've used those methods to get elected, it becomes incredibly hard to govern responsibly for all citizens in bringing people together and getting big things done. Because once you start, you know, churning up anger, it just feeds on itself. And if you're not continually throwing fresh raw meat at it,
right,
it will get away from you entirely.
Now throw in a little ineptness in there and a complete inability to read a room, and voila, you have exactly what's happening in Canada right now. Is he a classic tyrant? Well, not exactly. But it's not through a lack of effort. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you were entertained and even a little educated. Please like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.